don't stop. Trunks pop, tops drops in the front end hop. Paint flop, screens on, that can bear in the zone. Years on, ride on, ballin' at my home. Texas place don't hate, showing up in the state. Can't wait, get it straight, by the front end break. Paint the cost, speed the boss, looking good when I fly. Sunshine, let it die, turn it up and climb. Roll around, hit your block, trunk going on high. Let it up, let it pop, light up the whole block. Southside, how we hold on a gangster throw. Music, you can go on, knocking off.
Do you know how much that one is? Yeah. See, that's what I was saying, because I thought it was $19.99, but I went on in there.
I just left a Goodwill over here close to the hood. Why the hell are my windshield wipers on? I really, really hate passing up on NES boxed games, especially in that condition. But I had no clue that Wear and Time, what the freak is it called? Wear and Time to San Diego. I know I'm screwing that up. Where in Time does Carmen San Diego something or another? It's just not a desired title, but I had no clue that it actually came with an encyclopedia and it's in a big box for the NES, or at least on the NES version. So if it's anywhere close to a decent price, even though it's not some a game that I would play, I'm picking it up just for the fact that it's cool that it comes in an encyclopedia and it's in a big box, but it wasn't. It was at $20, the price. So, I don't know. Maybe those guys are smarter than I take them for. They knew it was a Nintendo game, and it's bigger than the normal Nintendo box, so I guess they decided to slap a $20 sticker on it. The game on Price Charting Complete is valued at $28.99. Now, that only comes from one sale per year, so they don't sell a lot on eBay. And again, it goes back to the fact that it's just not a very desirable title, I think. So, for $20, I just couldn't do it. All right, guys, on to the next one.
Chris just walked in here from his car and broke a sweat. came in here looking like he just came out the sauna. I
believe you. All right, we'll get to it. Thanks.
So now they're trying separation and sending black folks in white coats to infiltrate our congregation, tapping into our conversation, saying the message that they get, bring forth wrong premeditations. So David's got a silver man. While listening to Brad, David gets mad and kills his dad. David Duke's got a shotgun. So why you get upset? Cause I got one. A disc, a task, a brother got his shot in the face by a cop close.
The other day when a subscriber commented on one of my videos and said that I was their hero, I said to myself, I am no hero. I am a man of many flaws and I am only a mortal. Then I thought to myself, wait a second. I can be a hero, a video game hunting superhero, but if only I could fly. I mean, when I was young and played basketball, I had a very high vertical leap. And friends used to say that I could jump out the gym. But jumping and being able to fly are entirely two different things. If I could fly, I could hit up 1,000 Goodwills in the speed of light. All the evil villains in my universe would be gameless. There would be no more punching infants in the face. There would be no more me so horny with plastic cup lids. That being said, where there is injustice in the world, I will be there. Where there are scanner-carrying greedy resellers, I will be there. Where there are eBay scammers, Super Mac and Z will be there. I must learn to fly immediately, off to the training facility.
miles of crusaders. Jamming to a tape that my partner made. Growing up in the hood, being mixed.
All right, so I picked up 8 Genesis games, loose cart Genesis games in that Goodwill, and one N64 game. Now, guys, I hate getting off work at 5 like I normally do, or a little bit later, and then it takes me an hour to get over to this side of town. So the people that get out of work at 5 are beating me to the punch a lot of the times. So I got off early today, and I'm glad I did, because I got to this particular Goodwill at 4:30, and there was a bunch of Sega Genesis games just laying right on the counter waiting for me, already priced. So yeah, so pick these up today. There's one or two titles in here that might be, that I've never heard of before in my life, but I did a little research. I cheated in the car before I filmed this video right here, and one or two of these might be some real freaking gems, guys. So we'll talk about that in the game room, and I'm out of here. Peace.
Got this love forming my life. Today, and indeed, not the form of life. That's a shame, I'm hanging for a love with dreams. Not afraid, not afraid to let you up and leave them. Do your thing, share the pain. It's with all my folks. Got high for the days that they were lost and broke shit. Got high.
Holy shit, guys, I don't know if you can see that. Look at that rainbow. You know what they say about rainbows? There's a pot of gold at the end of a rainbow. Let's find the end of this rainbow and see what it has in store for us. Let's go. All right, guys, so I found the end of the rainbow. It's a little hard to see now because it's faded, but it actually goes into the top where the roof is on this Goodwill. So that means inside of this Goodwill lies my pot of gold. So let's go inside and see what we find. Yes!
young black male. Some see me stranded in this land of hell, jail, and crack sales. Hustle and hardly make a culture. Or the repercussions while busting on backstabbing vultures. Selling my soul for material wishes. Fast cars.
Hey, what's up, everybody? So we're gonna do this recap video in the closet. Let me know what you guys want or what looks better. I think the lighting is better in here, but I don't know, whatever. So I decided to do it in here. I thought it would be quicker. I tried to do this video once and it took forever. I was talking about everything for so long. I got a lot to get to, so I'm gonna try to run through this quick because I want to get this video uploaded as fast as possible. All right, MVP Baseball 2005 EA Sports. This is the last year that EA Sports did MVP Baseball. I mentioned to you guys before about this. I picked this up three times now in the past couple of years. It's not in the big box, it's loose, but I can make $50 off of this game. And I'm talking about sold listings I'm looking at. So believe it or not, I can make $40 to $50 off of this game. So this is going to pay for the majority of what I picked up. This might pay for everything that I picked up, actually. I haven't done the math, but there's another game that I'm selling that's going to put money in my pocket. So that's what it's all about. Collecting and paying for your collecting by picking up stuff you can sell. Now, next, let's go through the PS2 games first. Spawn Armageddon. This is a game that I've never seen before. It got mixed reviews. It got compared a lot to Devil May Cry, which I'm a big fan of, and it's something that I'm interested in playing. I think it's an original story by Todd McFarlane, and what else? Marilyn Manson did the soundtrack on this game, which is pretty cool, and like I said, it's a Namco game. It got mixed reviews. I think IGN gave it a very high score, and then GameSpot gave it a very low score. So it's complete, and I'll be trying that out. Maybe I'll do a Let's Play of that, or I don't call it Let's Play, but whatever. Then, a game that I picked up today that I'm very excited about getting. I've been looking for this game for a couple of years now, and I never see it out there, and finally found it today. By the way, I got that Spawn for $3.99. And I paid $1.99 for the MVP Baseball 2005, which is not bad at all. Area 51 is supposed to be one of, and I didn't even know this till I saw a video of it a year and a half ago, I think. But when I was doing some research after I picked it up today, it's supposed to be one of the best FPS games on the PlayStation 2. It's got David Duchovny from X-Files, Powers Booth, and Marilyn Manson again. I don't know if he's the alien or what the hell's going on. But very cool stuff here, guys. Area 51. And that's complete as well. And then now let's go over the Sega Genesis games and one N64 game that I picked up at the same time at a Goodwill. All these games are $2.99 a piece. So I picked up Fantasia, Sonic 3 the Hedgehog, which I did not have in my collection. Stimpy's Invention, Street Fighter 2 Special Champion Edition. Then we have a shooter, man. The great thing about the Sega Genesis is there's so many great shooters out there, and some of the shooters people don't even know about. Never even heard of this game, Biohazard Battle, and it's supposed to be a really good shooter. And the main thing about this shooter is it has some of the best music in any shooter that you will ever play. So I cannot wait to play that game to see what the music sounds like. All right, Hey You Pikachu, again, $2.99. And then picked up a classic that I do not have in my collection until now, Altered Beast. Then we have the most expensive out of those tiles. This game's worth like, I think, 16 or 17. Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. And then another game that I did not know anything about, Target Earth. you're like a robot, and it's a platformer, but it's open world. You can go right or left. Supposed to be hard as balls, this game, Target Earth. The guy that was doing the review that I checked out last night said you will never beat that game. But I think there's a cheat code on it. But he's like, without the cheat code, you'll never beat that game. Let me know, guys, if you've played Target Earth and if you've played Biohazard Battle. All right, now moving on. So this is all one pickup. This is my best pickup of the week. Obviously, let me have a little sip of my Pilsner Kale real quick. This is kind of a throw-in. I could have left this. Could not research it. It comes with the directions. When I was at the Goodwill, I could not get on the internet. So it came with the directions. Sega CD. It's Sega CD, Sega Classics Arcade Collection. One of those things I could have left, but whatever. Now, let's go over the... I'm not going to open all these up, I don't think. I guess I could. So the first game I picked up, it was weird because they're all priced differently. And the guy that at the register was like, well, I think they went on eBay. That's why they're priced differently. And I was thinking, well, if they went on eBay, they would never price games like this. 99 cents for Bubsy 2 on the Sega Genesis. That's complete. It's got the registration card, everything. Then we have Shanghai Dragon's Eye, I guess, for $1.99. Complete. All these games I do not have except for... I do not have complete except for Sonic 2. No, you know what? I don't even think I have the directions on Sonic 2. So now we have Sonic Spinball. That's complete. $1.99. Sonic the Hedgehog 2, not for resale. $1.99. Complete. Next up, you saw me pick up Sonic 3 over there. But now I have it complete. This is $1.99. Very nice shape. Next up, we have Columns 3, $1.99. Very, very nice shape. Then we have Lotus Turbo Challenge, $1.99. It's also complete. And I'm going to save the best for last. Aliens 3, for whatever reason, this was $3.99. Like, they're all over the place. It's also in good shape, and that's complete. And then the three best pickups that I picked up this week, guys, are Sonic and Knuckles. I picked that up for $2.99. It's like a $30 game. All these games I'm going to show you right here are in pretty good shape. I need to remove the tape on this one. I thought I did that already. Had to do that on the next two games, but I guess I forgot to do it. I don't know if I'll open all these up for you guys, but trust me, they're complete with the directions. Now, what I learned from this game right here, which is really cool, and I did not know. I guess I should open it up for you guys. Let me see. Is this the one? Yeah. So, when I first opened this up, I just thought, okay, it was just, they decided to do a weird-looking cartridge. But apparently, I guess when Sonic the Hedgehog 3 came out, they rushed it out. And so there was a lot left that was unfinished, I guess. So Sonic and Knuckles is basically like a continuation of Sonic 3. I think if they had to do over again, it would have been these two games put together. But the cool thing about it is I guess you can open this up and then you can slide this Sonic 3 into it. And then you can play with Knuckles and you can play like the whole entire game. Also, you can put Sonic 2 in here and make Knuckles an unlockable character, I guess. So, yeah, man, that's pretty cool. And then Sonic Knuckles is a game onto itself also. You don't have to put Sonic 3 or 2 in there, and it's its own freaking game, which is really nice. All right, now, the best pickups of the week are Doom 32X in very nice shape. And I'm not going to open it up, but it's complete. Got that for $1.99. And then we have Knuckles Chaotic. $1.99, guys. This is one of my better pickups in a long freaking time. Did not know until I got home how much this was worth. This is worth about $75. And I picked it up for $1.99. Now listen, Sega 32X games, they only made 40 32X games. And I just picked up two complete copies of 32X games out of the 40 that were ever made. So this is a kind of a little rarefied pickup here. I guess I can take it out for you guys. And it just looks like it's never been played. It's in great shape. There's the directions inside of there. So yeah, man, Chaotic Knuckles and Doom. So I don't have a 32X, so I'm selling this. I'll make about 75 off of that. I should be able to make 50 off the MVP Baseball 2005. That's going to pay for everything I've showed you guys and put money in my pocket, and that's what it's all about. So I'll be able to collect and do the same thing next week for you guys. All right, hope you enjoyed the video, and I will talk to you guys later. Youngsters, put down those cigarettes. Peace out, my brothers.